Christine with the news.
No.
Turn on the news.
This is the Herdline News.
Have you ever been around someone who has their camera phone out and they're doing videos and they just put you on the video and you don't want to be?
I don't think I'd like that.
It happens all the time. I know
in
a lot
life?
Of people. Yeah, and maybe it's a younger generation thing, but yeah, there's people who will just, you know, put you on their Insta story or their Snapchat without asking you. And sometimes I don't really want to be on camera.
Of course.
Okay, so some of the Cavs players took a trip on the New York subway on Monday.
They did?
Yeah. And they started doing that same thing we just were talking about, putting the camera on the people in the subway. And needless to say, one of the guys was not so happy about it. So here's the video.
On our way back from shoot around, decided to take a different transportation this time. Where we at, Kyle?
On the train, we had two options. 45-minute bus ride.
45-minute bus ride. Or a 6-minute train ride. So we decided to hop on the train with the squad.
Hey, Channing, what's up?
What's the question? I don't know this dude right here. He's tripping.
He said, can you not? Okay, so listen, good. I'm glad they took the subway. They're having fun. I'm all about that.
Yeah.
Put that on your Insta story.
Yeah.
But don't put other people on your story or film them without asking. That's just rude. And this guy, the one who said, can you not, I think this was on his Facebook. He said, listen, it was first thing in the morning. I hadn't finished my latte and I didn't feel like being filmed. Plus, it's not good lighting in the subway. Like, I get it. I don't want to be on camera. And so I think that was pretty funny.
Oh, that was funny, yeah.
But it's also a message to everyone. Don't just assume that you can use people, because a lot of times they're like making fun of them almost in a way. Like, oh, look at this guy on the subway that I'm squishing.
Yes. What's squishing mean? Is that a...
No, like squishing, you're squishing him. Okay. He said that he was just taking up all the seat and just really unaware of the personal space, which also, I want to say this. If you're riding public transportation, like the T, the subway, whatever it is, if there's a woman there, especially pregnant, or an elderly person, man or woman...
Give them space.
Give them some space.
Yes.
Let them sit. So, the Cavs were down by 23 points in the third quarter yesterday and came back to beat the Knicks by 3 points. Mm-hmm. And then LeBron, of course, took to his Instagram account.
After the game?
Yeah, after the game.
Oh, okay.
To send a message to Knicks fans, and he posted this picture of him on the court and said, "You're welcome, King of New York, my favorite playground, strive for greatness."
How do you get that picture? That's great.
Well, that's a good question. It takes, you know, someone probably had to send it to him.
Yeah.
Maybe edited, photoshopped, I'm not sure.
That's great.
But listen, if it takes you having to make a massive comeback to beat the previously 7-5 Knicks by 3 points, don't brag.
I think that's funny. You know what I love? Basketball in New York is so great.
Uh-huh.
I mean, that's really a meaningless game. But when you're watching it on TV, it totally pops. In like the Saturday Night Live crew was all sitting in the first row, and D-Wade was eye to eye with... There's something about... And I don't even know what it is. Like, LeBron talked about it afterwards. There is something about basketball in New York. It is simply different. Maybe it's like college football in the South.
Well, it's like... Well, first of all, it's Madison Square Garden. It's the lighting. The fact that it's dark, and then it's light on the court, which is the same thing that the Lakers do.
So they show the stars.
Yeah, and it's the star appeal. There's celebrities there.
It felt...
Knicks basketball has a lot of tradition. Plus, let's not ignore the fact that it was the Cavs in town. So that's why people are watching.
Right.
Okay. And finally, we spent a lot of time yesterday talking about whether Ben McAdoo would be fired during the season or if they would wait until the end. And now we are hearing from the Giants owners, John Mara and Steve Tisch. They said Ben McAdoo is our head coach and has our support, and they will not fire him during the season. They're going to reevaluate afterwards what kind of changes they need to make. But they said they realize their fans are upset. But they're going to continue their tradition of not evaluating during the season and letting everyone know.
That's very New York. That's very New York Giants. Generally, the Yankees and the Giants, not the Knicks or the Mets or the Jets, but the Giants and the Yankees, there's sort of this austere, you know, kind of this dignified approach. And so that's kind of the way they run. Christine with the news.
Well, that's the news.
And thanks for stopping by.
The Herdline News.
There is a lot of news out there, and Peter Schrager in New York via the Coward Global Center.